Today, friends, I'm going to show you how to use Tinkercad to make that design in just a few minutes. So let's get cracking. All right, so this was a post on Facebook just asking how to make these holes. I've got a technique. Here we go. If it's your first time using Tinkercad, you can get there by visiting www.tinkercad.com. I prefer sign in with Google. We're going to create a brand new 3D design. The user called these sound holes, so let's name the project sound holes. That's how easy it is to name a project. I'll real quickly show you how we can go back to the dashboard. You can see this is our project. These are other projects I'm working on. There will be an image here after a little while. I'm not going to wait though. I simply want to return to Tinker This. So we are going to create that cool shape with the tube. The tube is awesome because you can simply type the numbers you want. Let's say the user wanted the outer one to be 40. Maybe they want the wall thickness to be 3. If they don't like that, they can simply change it. Let's go to 25 and 2. That's how easy it is to adjust them. Notice this is the radius, so it is really size 50. I'm going to just do Control D, which is duplicate. I'm going to take the next one and I'm going to subtract 10 to get 15. Notice that is not the distance I would probably want, so I can change it to 20 until I find the right pattern. Control D again. Once again, let's take away the 5. And let's do one more just for giggles. Control D and make it 10. We would then take this and cut out the center chunk. You can pick how much that would be. I'm going to stretch it across, do L for a line, and of course I want it to be centered this way. I can center it this way, but it doesn't really matter. When I select these and do Control G, all of a sudden you can see we've got the cutout middle that was on the user's pattern. Now if you want to make a different one, check it out. We can simply do Control D, move the other one to the side, and then I'm going to ungroup and I'm going to just adjust the numbers. So I know that I think I want this to be thinner. Select that and do L for a line again and get it so it's to the right spot. And I think I might not even want that one. And then maybe each of these I want to be 2.5 instead. So you can tweak and adjust this to get the right pattern for whatever you were trying to make. You could even do something crazy like make that one thicker. You have complete control. Once again, do Control G to get the pattern that you want. We're going to take both of these and we're going to make them holes. Now remember that user had a box. Of course, we could use the cube, but instead I'm going to search for a special one called the soft box. This one is pretty slick because it gives us beveled corners. Please understand that we always type the parameters. If you stretch the handles, it does break this. So I'm going to just make this 60 by 90. I'm going to keep Z at 20. Size 3 walls are perfect. And then I want to add a lid. I'm going to do Control D. So you can see we have two of these. I'm going to make the wall more than 30. So that way it fills all the way across. Of course, I do want to shrink the height. I'm going to change that to 3. After a moment, it'll snap into place. We can do L for a line. I want this to be the boss, and of course, it needs to be to the top, to the center, and to the center. Now we can grab our part from underneath. I'm going to do Control up to raise it up. And if we do Control G, I'm not going to group this piece. I'm going to hide it. Let's do L for a line. Snap. Snap and Control G, we have just cut in the sound pattern in our shape. How cool is that? Friends, as I wrap up, of course, I want to say thanks to Patty for the question. Absolutely love the Facebook groups. You really need to take a moment to check them out. I also want to say thank you to everybody that's supporting me via YouTube memberships. There are 3 different levels of support, starting as low as $5. And one of my favorite things is that with any support, you get early access to the videos. Also, a huge shout out to my supporters via Patreon. Love how that group is growing. There is a fantastic discussion area. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.